Good morning, Team Bodyfit. Welcome to yoga. Beginner's yoga here. So all you'll need is a mat and a little band if you feel like that you're not that flexible. Remember, this is just the beginning side of yoga. So if you're a real yogi, you just go straight ahead and go into every move. Otherwise, we'll just take it nice and easy and show everybody how to get into those poses and do what's best for their spine and their body. Okay, is everybody here? good morning. Okay, make sure that you've checked with your doctor or your physio whether these exercises are right for you. And remember, thanks Tina for sending in the pictures yesterday. So remember, when we open up, go back up to any of the body fits and pick up a bag. Perfect. So send me the photos of your training. We'd love to see them. Here we go. I don't know if you can hear my music. If you can't hear my music, put anything on that you like. Morning. So that's my bed. Maybe we'll get it later. I'm just going to start off putting my hands on my rib cage. Big breath in. And then sighing out through your mouth. Still losing my breath. Big breath in. And then sighing out through your mouth. You want to expand your rib cage out to the side and then draw it back in again. So you're doing those really big morning. No, be careful of your spine. Morning, Chef. Take off that dressing gown. Big breath in. And then sigh out. So see how my fingers are expanding to the side because I'm filling up my rib cage as big as I can with all the air. And then I'm breathing out through my mouth and letting my fingertips draw back down again. Big breath in. And then sighing out. Let your shoulders drop back and down as you sigh out. So you want to let that upper body relax down as you breathe out. Big breath in. And then sighing out. Perfect. And again, big breath in. And then sighing out. Let's do two more like that. Big breath in. And then sighing out. Out through your mouth. So if you're stressed at any stage, screaming at the kids or the dog, big breath in. And then sighing out. Good, let's do two more. Are you with me, Jan? Big breath in. And then sighing out. Good. Here we go. We're going to float our hands all the way up over our head. Grab a pistol grip like you're one of Charlie's Angels. All the way up. Squeeze your hands together. I'm going to lift up nice and tall. I want you to squeeze your bottom, squeeze your quads, and squeeze your inner thighs in together. Good. Lifting up nice and tall. Then relax your shoulders down and squeeze your arms to your ears. From here, I'm going to go from side to side, but I'm not going very far. I'm just going to go over and start to warm up my back. Lifting up and over. Good. You keep going and I'll keep talking. Hi Sarah. Hi Harley. Hi Emily. Hi Poppy. Hi Pippa. Hi Ashley. Reach all the way up. Thanks for joining us. Good. So when you've gone just side to side a few times and you're starting to feel warmer in your spine and a little bit more flexible, then you can go a little bit deeper. But for people with a bad back or a bad spine, I'm going to put my hand on my hip and then go over to support my hip. So if that's enough, you can use that. That'll protect your lower back. But remember, when I'm going up and over, I want to squeeze my butt. Squeeze my hamstring, so I'm not just hanging out there. So here we go, big breath in, lift up nice and tall, shoulders back and down, squeeze your butt, and then go over. Push that hip out, reach those arms long to the back of the room. See, your hip will want to turn to help you out, but you want to bring it back in, squeeze your butt, draw in your trousers, and reach those arms long. Keep breathing. Good. Looks good from here. You look perfect. Remember to relax those shoulders down so your neck's not doing any of the work. And squeeze those arms towards your ears. Push it out a little bit further now. Pull your hands back. side. Have a look at your shoulders, have a look at your hips. Push that hip out. If you feel it through your lower back, pop your hand there. If you've got a wall and you want to help through the wall, you can put your hands on the wall. You should be getting a great big stretch all the way down your side and all the way through your spine. If you're nice and flexible, you're going to take this bottom hand and pull your top hand. Remember to relax your neck. Now we've got all the upper body looking great. From here you look perfect. Squeeze your quads. Pull up at the top of your kneecap. Good. Drop down a little bit lower. Keep pushing. Pull those arms back. Just a little bit more. Good. One more prayer. And then breathe out to come all the way up. From here, float your hands down. Oh, a little shoulder. Nice and easy. Good work. From here, come all the way back up again. Reach up. We've got that Charlie's Angel grip. Reach up high. Squeeze your quads. From here, you're going to let your head drop back. So all I'm doing is letting my head drop back. I'm still squeezing my butt. Head drops back. Push your hips forward a little bit. Relax your neck. Are you doing that? Let me have a little look. Hi there. Hi, Latina. So let your head drop back. Reach to the ceiling. I want nice long arms reaching up. Head drops back. Still breathing it out through your nose. Down a little bit here with this. Touch the ceiling with your fingertips. Good. See if you can even up your hips. And then if you're feeling okay, we're going to take our fingers and draw them along the back wall. So I'm trying to draw my hands back, but I don't want to be doing a back bend. So push those hips forward, squeeze your butt, squeeze those elbows close to your ears and relax your head. Still breathing in and out through your nose. Good. From here, lift all the way up. Oh, beautiful. We're going to float down towards the floor. Bend your knees and then touch the floor. Hang here. Just hang. Let your head relax. Your shoulders relax. You're hanging down now. From here, we're going to roll up one vertebrae at a time. So tuck your chin, bend your knees forward, and then roll up one vertebrae at a time. Squish your back. Head comes up last. Tuck your chin. Good work. Let's do it all again. Big breath in. Hands clap together. Pistol grip. Reach up tall. Over to one side. Breathing out. Reach your arms long. Keep breathing. Relax your head. Relax your shoulders down your spine. Squeeze through your inner thighs and push your hip out a little bit more. So you look like a half a moon now. Take your fingertips. Draw them back a little bit more. See if you can just go down just a little bit lower and pull your arms straight. You've got 3 breaths left here. Lower back issue, put your hand on your hip, support your lower back. Last breath now. Good, we're going to breathe out to come up. But if it feels it, if you feel it in your lower back, take your hand on your hip to come up. Breathe out, come all the way up. Beautiful. Lift up tall again, squeeze through your inner thighs, breathe out, go over. Now these shoulders want to bend around to try and help your arms out. You want them to be nice and straight across. So see if you can keep them nice and straight across. Good. Looks good. Now squeeze your butt again. Go a little bit deeper. Draw up at your trousers and your pelvic floor. Keep reaching, pull those arms long, Sarah, just a little bit more. You've got 3 more breaths. Remember, if you feel it in your lower back, hand them to the hip. We're going to breathe out, come up, and I want that transverse to switch on that lower tummy muscle. Breathe out to come up. Beautiful. Here we go, that little dropping of your head back. So squeeze your bottom, let your head drop back. Relax your neck. Now, if you've got a neck issue, you're going to get rid of these hands and pop your hands behind your head and just relax your head back there. So your hands are going to support your neck just a little bit, but you'll still get two more breaths. Lift up a little bit higher. Push your hips forward just a little bit more. Pull your hands back just a little bit more. One more breath now. Good work. Coming all the way up. Remember, we're going the other direction now. So draw up that transverse. Reach forward. Bend your knees. And you're still long enough in that spine. And then relax your head. Relax your shoulders. We're down here for a few breaths. So really see if you can relax everything down. So I want to see if I can just let everything hang. Get the weight even through your feet. So I want weight at the front of my feet, back of my feet, and down the side, like a tripod. Just hanging. Now from here, we're rolling up. So start to squeeze through your inner thigh, squeeze your butt. Breathe out, roll up. Head comes up last, remember? Good. And then go all the way back to the top. We're going to an awkward position now. So I'm going to just, like I'm doing Pilates, reach my arms forward. You're going to sit down in a little chair. So sit your body back and sit down in that little chair. Drop your shoulders back and down. Now the weight's in your heels. So I want my butt and my hamstring to be firing. I also want my transverse to be switching on. Like I'm reaching out to you. Draw your shoulders back and down. See if you can touch me. Lift up at your chest. Relax your shoulders. Sit your body back down a little bit more. Check out your knees haven't flared out or knocked in too much. They're in line with your second toe. Good work. Now breathe out. Come all the way up. Float your hands to the top. Circle them around. We'll do that just one more time. Here we go. Breathe in. Sigh out, sit down. Sit down in that little chair. When you're down here, remember to switch on at that transverse, that lower tummy muscle. It weights in your heels now. So wiggle your little toes. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Hi, Jude. Drop your shoulders back. Sit down a little bit further. Good work. I want to feel like my hamstrings are really working and my quads. But if it's too hard, remember you could use a balancing the wall. Sit down a little bit lower. Relax your shoulders. Lean back at the end. Squeeze your butt. Draw up at your transverse. Breathe out to come up. Put your hands around. Perfect. Looks good. This time, up on your tippy toes like a ballerina. And then float down. And again, up on your tippy toes. And then float down. Good. If you're feeling a little bit wobbly, hold the wall or hold the chair, whatever you've got close, the dog, the cat, the kid, up and down. I want to feel like my ankles and feet are all warmed up as well. Squeeze your quads, float up, and then float down. Shoulders are back and down. Looks good. Then from here, we're going to stay up on our tippy toes. Stay up on your tippy toes. If you've been drinking too much last night, this will be hard work, so use the wall. Drop your shoulders back and down. We're going to float down. I want a nice straight spine as I go down. I want to squeeze my quads. If you're holding the wall, hold the wall, that's okay. I want to lean back so my shoulders and my hips are over each other. Bad knees, don't go very far. Good knees, you need to go a little bit further like you're sitting in a little chair. And then float all the way up. And then down again. Beautiful. That was great. Let's do it again. Come all the way up. Push into your knee toe. Float down. Knees track forward. Don't let them flare out. Good. Then if your body's leaning forward, you've got to push it back. You're looking for a little bit of a shake in your quads. Just starting with warm up. How's that feeling? Could you go a little bit lower? Lean back just a little bit more. Lift up at your heels just a little bit more. We're looking for a shake. Give me a little bit of a shake. Woo! Good. And then come all the way up. Perfect. Next one. Knock your knees together. Knock them here. Hey, Jane. You're on your hands. There you go. Knock your knees together. Reach up. Come up on your tippy toes. Use the wall if you need to. Float down. squeeze your quads together. Your heels are off the floor and you don't have to go very far. And then flare. Perfect, let's do one more. Knock your knees together. That's just so I get a laugh. No, not really. Here we go. Drop your shoulders back and down. Squeeze from the knees to your hips. Heels off the floor. Float down, just a little way. Keep squeezing. Good. And then flare. Heels back and down. Beautiful! Looks great! Here we go. Into pulling mode. I'm going to take my hand out, turn it over so you can see the palm. Grab the inside of your foot. Hold the wall if you want to. So find a quad stretch, but your hand's not on the outside, it's on the inside. I'm going to push my foot against my hand, drag my hand in. So I'm constantly pushing the body. Then start to lean your body forward. If you're using a wall and it's your first time, use the wall, lean your body forward, push forward. If you're an expert, reach your hand forward, your indicating bow. Keep breathing, keep stretching. Keep pushing your little toe up towards the ceiling. Keep pushing it up. Trying to get it up over your head. Hard to balance when you've got the rest of the family running underneath you, I know. You're doing a great job, Joe. Keep going. And it doesn't matter if you fall out. You just come back again. Here we go, float down. Perfect. Look great from here. Let's try the other side. Hang out. Pick up your foot. Put your knees together. Squeeze your butt. Push your hips forward. Push your foot against your hand. Reach your hand up if you're going straight into it. Breathe out, let's go forward. If you're not and you're using a wall, that's okay. Push your foot against your hand and then start to go forward. Tap your chin. When you're a beginner and you're on the wall, you might want to think, oh, now I'll take my hand off the wall. I can do this. Pull up at your core. Keep breathing, keep reaching. Looks good. Push your foot up, just a little bit higher. Keep breathing. Drop your belly down. Two more breaths. Last breath now. And then come all the way back. Let your hand down. Beautiful work. Excellent job. So look, you do it on the toe on each side. So now you know exactly what to do. Hand out, pick up your foot, or whichever foot, from the inside. Reach your contour. Breathe out, float forward. Push your hand against your foot. Keep reaching, keep lifting that foot until it's all the way up over your head or close. Two more breaths. Last time now, and then come all the way back. Try the other side, hand out, pick up on the inside of your foot, push your foot against your hand, reach your hand up, strong with this arm, push, and then off you go. Reach forward. Keep pushing and pulling, so there's constant pushing and pulling here. This is always pushing and pulling. That'll allow you to float down a little bit longer and keep your balance more. You keep doing that, I'll tell you about this. Pull up at the quad of the leg you're standing on. So that is really strong. Those muscles there are switching on lots. Two more breaths. Drop your chest down a little bit more if you can. Lift your leg up a little bit higher if you can. Perfect. Float down. Excellent job. We're going to go into eagle next. So I'm going to take my hands and start off easy. Just swing one hand underneath the other. It doesn't matter which hand. Wrap it around like ropes. Pull it down. Good. Tony, are you doing this? Pull your arms down. See if you can get them underneath. If you're flexible enough, keep putting it down. Good. Put your tight through your shoulders and your back and your arms. This is hard work. So you just do the best you can. So if it's too tight, wrap your hands around. Just give yourself a big hug. That's where you're going to today. Put those arms down. Sit down a little bit lower. So I'm sitting down, like I'm sitting in a little chair that somebody's pulling away from me. And I'm going to lean my chest back at the end. Good. One more breath. And then you come all the way out. Let your hands up. Swing the other arm underneath this time. Other arm underneath. Sometimes that's confusing. Which one? Drop it down. Usually the girls tell me. So pull it down as far as you can. See if you can get your shoulders in line. So they don't want to be like this, they're going to be straight. Straight across. So see if you can get them straight across. Pull your elbows down. See if you can get your palms in line with each other. If not, grab them. Keep putting them down. Sit down in that little chair. Good. How's that feeling? Pretty good? I'm trying to get my elbows, my wrists, underneath my nose, and in line with my knees, so not out to the side. Sit down a little bit further. Remember, you're sitting down in a little chair, and then you're leaning back at the end. Good. And then breathe out. Take your hands all the way up, give a big clap, yay, and then float them down. We're going to add our legs next. So reach up nice and tall. Wrap your hands around like ropes. I don't care which one, anyone will do. Pull it down. Shoulders are nice and even. Pick up your leg. You're sitting in that little chair. Swing it over. Good. And then sit down further. Hips are even, elbows even. Maybe you can wrap that toe around the back of your calf. Good. Sitting down low in that little chair. And then lean back. Just a little bit. Lean back. Good work. Sit down a little bit lower. And remember, if it's too much, stay sitting in that little chair. One more breath. Lean back. Sit up tall. Good work. Come all the way out. Big breath in. Swing the other arm underneath. Oh, no, this way. I don't know if you're right. Here we go. Sit down in that little chair. I want to feel the stretch in between my shoulder blades. Pull those arms down underneath. See if you can get those fingertips to even up. Elbows in line with your knees. That's enough for you. Stay there. Otherwise, pick up that leg. Squash it around. Take that foot all the way behind. Sit down a little bit lower. And then once you're comfortable, see if you can get everything in alignment. And then sit back at the end, just a little bit. Good. Sit down a little bit lower, just as you can. Two more breaths. Lean back. Shoulders even. Pull those elbows down. Good work. And then come all the way up. Big breath in. And then sign now. Let's do a little spine stretch, a twist just because we can. We're going to pop your hands into prayer. Sit down in that little chair again. Twist through your torso. Drop down, hinge your knee, and look towards the ceiling. So I'm using my elbow and my knee as resistance against each other. I'm pushing and pulling, really twisting. Let your neck look towards the ceiling. Have you got it? Good work. It looks too hard, Rita. I had a coffee. Oh, good on you. You just keep watching, Rita. This is the easy one, Rita. I do it for you. Good work. Come all the way up and then breathe out. Let's go to the other side. Little prayer. Sit down. Maybe recovery will be for you, Rita, on Monday. That's just a stretch. Or Pilates tomorrow. You like Pilates? Look towards the ceiling. Have a big twist. Try not to let your knees knock together like I just did. Lean back. down a little bit lower. Keep twisting through your spine. Good. And then breathe out. Come all the way back up. Let your hands down. We're going to do a little bit more. This time we'll reach our arms long. So prayer position. Sit down in that little chair. Stick your butt out. Twist round. Then if you're okay, take your hands longer. Keep twisting. Keep pushing. Keep looking towards your fingertips. I want the stretch from the top of my head all the way down to my tailbone. Deep breath in and then sign out. Reach a little bit higher. Look a little bit further along the wall. Tracy, you with me? And then back to the center. And then float all the way up again. Breathe. Good work. Let's do the other side. Hands up. Big breath in, sign out. Sit down. Twist from Mima. Jen, you should be doing this with me. And then reach your arms long. Look towards the ceiling. So first of all, you might feel like the neck won't twist very far. I keep looking at the wall in front of you. But then, let your eyes go up the wall to the ceiling. Now you're looking towards the ceiling and you're twisting through. Big breath in. And then sign out. Reach the ceiling one more time. Good. And then all the way back to the center. Bring your hands back, to the center, and then all the way up. Let your hands down. Beautiful. We're going to go single leg stretch. So I'll take my feet apart as far as I can. Turn your toes in. Reach your hands up over your head. Breathe out to lengthen them. Shoulders drop down. Like a swan, you're going to dive down. Squeeze your quads, breathe out, start to float down. Look at me until you can't see me anymore. So keep looking, keep looking, keep looking, and keep looking, keep looking, and then grab the back of your hamstrings, bring your hands down, and pull yourself down. Now you're looking towards the floor, you're trying to get your forehead in between your feet. If that's too much, bend your knees. Have your hands on your knees and just hang down here. Otherwise, hands on the floor, just here. If it's too far down, grab something, probably not a wall, but a block or a pillow, anything you've got, and you can pop your hands there and just hang. We want to lengthen through your hamstrings and then through your lower back and then start to move up through your spine. But it's whatever position you're at today. So don't worry, wherever you're at is good enough. Okay, now, remember the weight is still even through my feet a little bit now, but now I'm going to roll forward on my toes just a little bit more. So more weight at the front of your toes. Really relax, your head down. If you've got behind your hamstrings, see you get your fingers underneath your feet, and pull yourself down. You really want to muscle in, feel flexible. Pull yourself down a little bit further. We're here for two more breaths. So pull yourself down for two more breaths. From here, start to squeeze your inner thighs. Release your hands, take them wide again, weight in your toes. Squeeze your quads. And like a swan, come back up. Chest up. Show me your chest. Look towards me. Beautiful. Squeeze your inner thighs. Bring your hands up. Step together. And then breathe out. Float down. Perfect. Let's try it again. Hands up. Breathe out. Step out. Turn your toes in. Reach your arms long. Shoulders back and down. Breathe out. Like a swan. Float down. Keep looking at me the whole body. Good. Nice long spine. Pretend I'm pulling from the crown of your head and the tailbone now. Keep floating down. Good work. Grab the back of your hand. Back of your hands. Back of your hamstrings. Pull yourself down. Grab the ball or whatever you need. And then let yourself hang here. Relax your head.
pulling yourself down. Remember, even though you're pulling yourself down, you're squeezing up at your quads. Roll the weight forward into your feet. Pull yourself down a little bit further. Let's do two more breaths. And being upside down, roll around to your head. So remember, if that's not for you, don't roll all the way. But if that is for you, you might look longer when you come back up.
Here we go.
Take your hands out. Squeeze through your inner thighs. Breathe out. Float up. Squeeze your butt. Good work. Step back together. Good breath in. And then sigh now. Excellent. Grab a little drink of water if you need it. We're going down to downward dog now. So here we go back to a downward dog. If you're unsure, we're going to dive out. Arms up. Big breath in. Sigh out. Dive out. Stick your bottom out. See your butt sticking out. Biggest butt in the room. Push it out. And then drop down. Hang down front. And then walk out into plank and into down. Into plank. Hold it here, shoulders back and down. If that's too much for you, go to your knees and go to your elbows. From here, I'm just going to stick my bottom up in the air. Stick your bottom up in the air and heels down to the floor. Shoulders back and down, roll your elbows in. Up again, up, tippy toes, and down to the floor. Two more, up there, tippy toes, and then down to the floor. Pretend I've got my hand in the middle of your back, and I'm pushing you back. Roll your shoulders in, or elbows in, so your lats engage a little bit more. Breathe. And then come back down into that plank again. Shoulders back and down. Too much off the toes, go to your knees, go to your elbows, whatever suits you. Tuck your chin, we'll just do it one more time. Here we go, stick your bottom up into downward dog. Walk your feet in a little bit closer this time. Up on the tippy toes, heels to the floor, chest to your thighs. Up on your tippy toes, heels to the floor, chest to your thighs. One more now. Good work. And then we're going into pigeon. So I want to lift one leg off the floor. You can go high, low, doesn't matter. We're swinging it through. Swing it through, tuck it underneath. Good. Let the other leg drop back. Didn't plan this very well, I don't think. Sit your bottom down if you can onto the floor. Reach your arms long. So now you're in pigeon relaxing. If that's too much for you, you can bend this leg in and just sit on the floor like this. If that's enough for you. Where sits you in your spine? But otherwise, I've got my leg all the way back. Pretend I've got your leg and I'm pulling it back further each time. Then I'm going to come from my bottom off the floor, so sitting up, reach long now. As long as you can go, and tuck your chin to your knee. We're here for three breaths. So I have a pause. I'm here for three breaths. Inhale, last breath, big breath in, and then sigh now. Draw your shoulders back and down. Pretend I've got a hook in your chest and I'm pulling you forward. So I'm pulling that chest forward. Tuck the back leg, tuck the toe underneath. Push yourself back up to plank. Good work. Take the other leg, go into a downward dog. Up on your tippy toes, heels to the floor. Take the other leg, swing it up and then swing it through. Drop it down. Good. Perfect. Remember, you can sit that bottom on the floor. If it's too hard, bend your legs. Sit like this. Good. And then reach nice and long. Karina, are you with me? Are you doing this? Pauline, is that right? Are you doing this? Then start to drop your body down.
You keep breathing, I'll keep talking. So it doesn't matter what exercises you do or what class you do, we can modify every class for you so it's adapted to what level you're at. So we have lots of people at the gym that come to my classes with lots of injuries. So we just need to adapt the exercises to suit you. So don't feel like you can't do anything because you've got an injury or you've got something, we can always adapt it to you. So dropping down, two more breaths. And then like I've got a hook in your chest, dragging your chest forward. Good. Tuck your toe on your knee. I'm going to go into that downward dog one more time. But this time, like a prancing pony, walk your heels. Push your chest back towards your thighs. Drop your shoulders back and down. Swing out those hips. Perfect. Two more. From here, I'm going back. Here we go again. Push your hips heavily on the floor. I want to tilt my shoulders heavily on the floor and then lift those hips. Good. Pushing them heavy into the floor. So lower back injury, you're not lifting your legs very far. If you're fine here, we're going to lift both feet off the floor and then down. And again, both feet off the floor and then down. Just a few more. Good. Two more now. From here, I'm going to take my hand beside me like a little sphinx. So draw your shoulders back, push your pelvis into the floor, roll your chest up like someone's pulling you with a hook. Or I'm pulling you with a hook through your chest. So chest comes up, pelvis pushes into the floor, look forward, and then take it all the way back down again. I want to feel like I'm a snake rolling up. So I want to feel like I can use my upper back to bring me up. So I don't really want to feel like my lower back is doing all the work. And then float back down again. Here we go again, shoulders back and down, and then floating up. Good. Let's do two more just like that. And again, if that's great for your spine and you don't need support through your hands, you can take them out to the side, roll your shoulders back, and then glide up. If your hands are too much out here, you can take them beside you. But remember what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get one vertebrae at a time to roll up nice and long, squeeze your butt, don't switch on the lower back first, and then float down. One more time. Shoulders back and down, pelvis into the floor, roll up. Good, and then taking it all the way down. Perfect, from here rolling up onto your hands and knees into a little cat stretch. So there's weight even through your four points on the floor. Shoulders back and down, tuck your chin. Scoop your pelvis underneath you, pull up at your transverse. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. And then shoulders back and down into cow. Drop your belly down, chin up, tailbone up. And then back the other way again. Scoop up that belly, like you're trying to get your tailbone to the back of the wall. And then float down. Again, you keep going. You're trying to get every little vertebrae moving by itself. So really slow and controlled with the breath. Let's do one more time now. All the way up. Good. And then floating all the way back down. Perfect. So we've gone both directions of our spine. We'll just do the other side as well. So we're going down into bridge. So spin yourself around, down into bridge. I'm going to tuck my pelvis underneath me. Can you see me here? Oh yeah. Tuck my pelvis underneath you. Squeeze your bottom. Tilt your pelvis. Roll up. One vertebrae at a time. Sorry, I'm using my voice. Push your hips up. And then roll down. One vertebrae at a time.
and get it not taut here. Rolling up one leg at a time. So we can start off with a Pilates bridge where you roll up and push your pelvis higher than your ribcage so your spine is nice and even. Then we can do that on the way down, one leg at a time, on the way down, trying to lengthen through each disc and vertebrae. And then after that, this time when we come off, we're going into a yoga bridge where we're going to push our ribcage up. Push all your organs towards the ceiling. So your hips, your ribcage, all towards the ceiling. Good. And then you drop the ribcage down and then roll back down one vertebra at a time. Perfect. Let's do it one more time. So here we go. Push everything up, ribcage up, hips up, squeeze through your inner thighs. If you feel it through the lower back, pop your hands underneath your hips. One more breath. And then back to neutral. Roll down, one vertebra at a time. Good. Grab one knee, pull it in towards your chest. Let the other leg hang down. Keep squeezing this leg in as much as you can. Changing over, come over here. If that's too much with a long leg on your back, lift your knee. Shoulders back and down. Tuck your chin. Good, and then from there, Savasana. Hands out, feet out, let the blood breathe. Two breaths. Grab your leg again, one more time. Pull it all the way in. So you're really muscling in. See if you can get your shoulders back and down on the ground. Perfect. Then release that leg. See if you can keep your hips even. Savasana, favorite. Relax. Be ready. Sigh out. Keep breathing. Deep breath in. Sigh out. You've done a fantastic job. We've done beginner's yoga now. You can lay here a little bit longer. Just breathe in and then sigh out. Letting that rib cage relax. Otherwise, that's it for me today. Yay. Thanks for joining me with my croaky voice. I'll see you tomorrow for Pilates. So you'll need a ball if you've got one, or a towel, a mat, a band if you need it. Grab whatever you've got laying around the house and we'll make it work. Thanks for joining me. Have a lovely day. Remember to do something nice for yourself and somebody else. Bye. See you soon.